That is the main gist. That is the main apropos I have for you guys. Bitcoin, Bitcoin, Bitcoin. That's what we're going to be talking about today on this channel. This was not meant to be today's topic, but I just knew I had to bring you guys into the know about everything that's been going on with Bitcoin in the news. So the what, the when, the how. I'm going to be spilling tea here today. You're going to be getting the whole gist in this video. My name is Ronke Odewumi and we are on the Bulletproof Life channel. Before we go further, take a minute to press the like button so that other fantastic people like you can get this video to watch. Once you press the like button, YouTube will share this video with other people like you so they can watch it. And if you haven't subscribed, press the red button to subscribe. So let's get into the whole Bitcoin gist. What is going on with Bitcoin? So for those who don't know what Bitcoin is a digital form of currency that was created in the 90s by a guy whose identity remains a mystery as a form of defiance to traditional forms of currencies as printed by national banks in countries all over the world. Bitcoin has been around since the 90s and is well known for being volatile, for having moments when it climbs right up and then it crashes right down. But this very last week, first week in January, Bitcoin went right up. The value of Bitcoin rose astronomically, and on Friday, Bitcoin ended on Friday at $41,000 per coin. Yes, Bitcoin was valued at $41,000. That's the first gist I'm bringing to you. By Sunday, it was at $40,300. That was what it closed for. And you know, those who had Bitcoin on Friday and Sunday were millionaires. Millionaires were created on Friday and Sunday last week. You know, while you were eating your noodles, while you were eating your takeaway, people were becoming millionaires because they had Bitcoin in their digital wallet. And then Monday came. Monday came in all its glory, and guess what? Bitcoin did what it likes to do. It crashed, it slumped, and on Monday, Bitcoin went down by over $8,000. It went down to about $32,000, which is still 700% more than what it was last year March. So if you're somebody who bought your Bitcoin last year March, 2020 March, yes, just when COVID was arriving, Bitcoin was going for about $5,000 a coin. Imagine if you bought it then, you'd be swimming in money now. And those are the people who are really cashing out. So even on Monday, despite the crash, Bitcoin was still going for $32,000. Now, why did it crash? If it was $41,000 on Friday, and you were sitting on it, you haven't sold it, why did it crash? Well, there were a number of reasons suspected for why Bitcoin crashed on Monday. A lot of financial analysts have speculated that a lot of macro traders are selling, they're liquidating their Bitcoin stock as they should. Like if I had Bitcoin and I bought it at $5,000, what do you think I'll be doing on Monday? I'll be selling it because I'm clearing out at 700% interest rate that you cannot imagine or fathom or get anywhere else. So of course people were selling and dumping their stock, and that's probably one of the reasons that brought down the value of Bitcoin. It also means that it's a product that's in a very unregulated market, because if it was a regulated market, there is no way that you would dump so much that you'd be able to crash the market that well. But that's really what happened with Bitcoin. So on Monday, the value of Bitcoin dropped. Now, as of today, it's picked up again and gone up from about 32,000 that it fell to on Monday to about $34,000, $35,000, you know, per coin. So it's rising back up. But the question is it going to keep rising or is it going to crash again? This is the first question. I want you to hold on to that because that's one question we have to deal with. The other thing is, why did it rise in the first place? Nobody really knows. A lot of financial analysts don't know. Are people buying? Is it responding to the US elections? Is it responding to economic situations all over the world? What is Bitcoin responding to? Why did Bitcoin rise? That is something that remains a big mystery. I'm not going to tell you I'm a Bitcoin expert because that is one investment I don't do. If you've watched my videos in the past, you will have seen where I said Bitcoin or cryptocurrency is one of those things I just don't invest in. And the reason why is because one is extremely volatile, which has been proved by the sudden rise and the sudden slump on Monday. So it's a really volatile investment. It's something you do with money you don't mind losing. And I'm just one of those people who never has money she doesn't mind losing. Like, I mind. I just mind. I don't want to lose my money. I don't want to throw my money at something that, you know, I'm very much likely to lose it. You know, that has a lot to do with risk appetite, you know? So my risk appetite means I'm somebody who doesn't invest in cryptocurrency or specifically Bitcoin because it's a volatile product. It's in a very unregulated market. A lot of governments have tried to look into it. You know, it's not regulated. There is blockchain in process to try and build some sort of safety net or regulation around Bitcoin, but that's not, you know, progressed very much. It still remains an interesting product to invest your money in. So no, I don't invest in Bitcoin. But anyway, my question is, for those who had Bitcoin and bought it at a really low rate, like $5,000 or even $10,000, when it got to $40,000 on Friday, why didn't you sell? There were people that held on to it, hoping for something, even though a lot of people who are specialists in Bitcoin market knew that that was really a peak price. Bitcoin getting to $40,000 was Bitcoin hitting its own peak. So for you to expect it to go beyond that, or for you to continue holding on to it, I don't know. I don't know what you're doing. I mean, I'm not somebody who buys Bitcoin, but if I have a stock or a share of a company or a mutual fund or anything that rises to a very high point, I'm selling it. Friends, at least I'm selling most of it. I'll keep some stake in it just in case it continues to rise. But of course, I will sell the majority. So for those people who sold their Bitcoins on Friday before the slump on Monday, let's be friends. Get in touch with me. I want to be your friend because you're obviously a millionaire now. So you and I can hang out. We are birds of a feather. You know, I'm birds of a feather. You know what they say? They flock together. So come and flock with me, you know, so let's hang out. So for those who didn't sell their Bitcoin, I commiserate with you. It's not too late to sell it. So I said to you earlier, will Bitcoin continue to rise? Or do I think it's going to crash further? I personally think the value is going to drop further. So this is a good time for you to sell your Bitcoin if you still have it. If you still haven't sold it after Friday's rise and Monday's slump and Tuesday's going back up again, this is a good time for you to sell your Bitcoin and maybe hold on to a little bit in case it decides to continue rising. This is not financial advice. Please don't take it as financial advice. It's simply Ronke's opinion of what I would do if I had Bitcoin and the value has shot up like that. So I'm thinking you should be selling now and cashing out. Still around this Bitcoin matter and the fact that it's volatile and unregulated, a lot of banks in the UK are now saying that for those who have sold their Bitcoin and they're cashing out, they shouldn't bring their deposits to their banks. As in, these banks are saying deposits of Bitcoin profits will not be accepted. Like, are you a hater? These banks are haters. Like, even though I won't invest in Bitcoin, can you say people who invested in Bitcoin shouldn't bring their deposits to your banks? Like, I'm not sure if this is written in stone or if these banks are really turning people back at the door, but that's the gist I heard, that you can't bring your Bitcoin profit as a deposit to the bank. I mean, how would they know? How would they know? They won't know. This is the part where I said they won't know. They won't know, but maybe they will. The point is, they don't want your deposit. Apart from that, the FCA has issued warnings about losing money on Bitcoin. They're saying if you're buying it now, you're going to be losing money. They're telling people, you know, that doesn't mean you should invest in Bitcoin. A lot of people now are jumping on the bandwagon. And I just feel like it reminds me of those days where people do MLM or MMM or pyramid schemes. And you get on it or you get into it when it's become popular, when people are cashing out, which is totally the wrong time to get on those things, even though those things are frauds. But the point I'm trying to make is that when it's become popular, it's too late. It's also a bit like the property market. When it becomes popular, when everybody's buying and buying becomes like a popular thing, you're probably getting in too late. The people who want to cash out have already cashed out. And I think it's the same way with Bitcoin. If you're just buying it today, if you're just buying it this week, I don't think you're going to cash out because you're buying it at premium. At $32,000, I don't think it's a good time to buy. I think it's a good time to sell. Or if you want to buy, just hold on a little bit and pray that my prediction comes true and the price goes down much, much, much more than it is now. And then you can jump in on it and hope for another sudden rise so that you can also cash out as a millionaire. Now, I have one extra gist for you. There is one guy, a developer called Stefan. That's his gist right there. That's the news about it. You can check the papers for that news. But before you go to the papers, let me tell you what's happening with Stefan. Stefan is a developer and he did some sessions about cryptocurrency and he was gifted Bitcoin you know, for talking about cryptocurrency. And I think he got 7,002 bitcoins at the time. At the time he was gifted the bitcoins, they were worth about $2 to $6. So he was given a decent amount, you know, even at that price. But anyway, Stefan was gifted 7,002 bitcoins. When the Bitcoin value rose on Friday, Stefan's Bitcoin was worth $240 million. Stefan was not just a millionaire overnight. It was an aggressive kind of money. Proper millionaire. Not 2 million, not 1 million. $240 million is the kind of millionaire that Stefan became. But you know when village people are on your case? You know when... I don't even know what was trying to get Stefan. But the point is, Stefan cannot remember the password to his digital wallet. I don't know if you've heard the story before, but if you have your Bitcoin or your cryptocurrency in a digital wallet and you forget your password and you enter it through too many times, there goes your money. Because you're going to not be able to access that wallet ever again, and that Bitcoin or that cryptocurrency is gone. So the problem now is that Stefan has forgotten his password and he has entered the wrong password 8 times. 8 times. 240 million is about to go. Stefan has entered his password 8 times and he has 2 more goes before this money will go into the clouds and Stefan will go back to being a normal person like the rest of us. Ha! I'm praying for Stefan. Stefan, if you are watching this video, I have you in prayers. I pray that you remember your password. I pray that the God of heaven will help you remember your password so that you can enter it and you can access your $240 million. And when you do, reach out to me, Stefan. I prayed for you. Let's fams. Let's be friends. You know that thing about birds of a feather flocking together. You and me, Stefan. We can be friends. You know, we can talk about money. I like talking about money. Stefan is the guy who needs to remember his password so he doesn't lose $240 million. Which brings me to another disadvantage of buying Bitcoin. The need to have a digital password that you cannot forget. Now, if you're like me, you will forget. Yes, if you're like me, if you're like Ronke, you will forget. Because I forget passwords all the time. It's like my modus operandi. It's my style. It's my thing. Forgetting passwords is my thing. So I'm like Stefan. So I'm feeling Stefan's pain to the bone. Some people have suggested that Stefan should simply have hired hackers who can help him find a back end into his digital wallet instead of trying the passwords repeatedly. He has 2 to go and Twitter has been agog about what Stefan should do to get his password back. So this is the Bitcoin gist I really wanted to bring to you. This is the Bitcoin gist I didn't want you to miss, so you're not going around trolling the newspapers looking for the gist. When you have me to give you money gist. So I had to bring you that Bitcoin gist. Bitcoin is rising. It's not a good time to buy. It's a good time to sell. Stefan, let's have him in our prayers. He's trying to remember his password so that he can stay a millionaire. Maybe Stefan will move to Monaco. He's German. But you know, Stefan can live the life when he has his 240 million. So we can have Stefan in our prayers. And I'm still not buying Bitcoin because I still don't have the kind of money that I don't mind losing. But if in future I have the kind of money I don't mind losing and my risk appetite changes because it can, and I become more risk friendly, I don't mind losing money because I have a lot, maybe I will start buying Bitcoin and then I will come back here to tell you all about my Bitcoin journey and how I'm buying low and selling when the price goes up. Because that's the way to make money in investing. Whether it's Bitcoin, whether it's the stock market, you have to buy when the market is bearish and then sell when the market is bullish. Guys, I hope you've enjoyed this my video, even though it's largely been about gist and news, but I just wanted to hang out with you and spill the tea and give you all the gist and tell you all about it. Because money conversations, money gossip, can be fun. We don't have to come here to gossip about other things alone. We can gossip about money, and that's what we are doing here on this channel today. If you've enjoyed this video and you still haven't smashed the like button, come on friends, please smash the like button so that YouTube can share this video with other like-minded people like you. Don't forget to drop me a comment. Let me know what you think about this whole Bitcoin saga. Are you a Bitcoin buyer? Are you buying? Are you selling? I mean, if you've made your millions, remember what I said, get in touch with me. Let's be friends. And don't forget to share this video with your friends. invite them to join the Bulletproof community. We are doing fun things here. We are doing wonderful things here. Until my next video, you take care of yourself and keep living that bulletproof life. Bye-bye.